Hey guys, it's Limegreengirly.nails, and what I have here is the new collection from Jenna Hipp Nail Polish Line, and it is called What's Hot Now, The New Candies. Now, I love this one so very, very much. The polishes are a little bit streaky and thin, but I picked them on purpose because today I'm going to be doing a Watermarble video. So I thought that the thin polishes would work really well. So I'm just going to go by the names. What I'm wearing now is one thin coat of Marshmallow Fondant, which is this cream. On my middle finger, though, I had to do two coats because it was streaky and you wouldn't be able to have the colors pop usually when you wear white for a Watermarble. So I did two coats on my middle finger. But everything else is one. So that's Marshmallow Fondant. This is called Creme The Cantaloupe, Pink Lady Finger, Violet Eclair, Trace Parfait, Thin Mint, Rose Tart, and American Pie. So those are all the 8 mini colors in this collection. So I'm gonna go ahead and start with my Watermarble. As I said, I already have my Marshmallow Fondant applied, so we're gonna be using all of these 7 colors to do the Watermarble today. So, as usual, what I'm gonna start with for my Watermarble is my room temperature water. I just got this from a regular bottled water, and I just let it sit out for a bit, so nothing real special about it. And I'm going to start by taping my fingers. I'm just using regular scotch tape. And I'm just going to take a piece. And I'm going to attach it here on my finger. Wrap it down and around. And I'm going to take a longer piece. Start up here. Bring it around. And back up, and then just fold this down and fold this over, and there we go. Now I'm just gonna do that to the rest of my fingers. Okay, so I just finished taping. I'm not gonna do my thumb in the Watermarble because it's just harder for me to maneuver it all in the bowl, but I am gonna be doing all my other 4 fingers. So I just finished taping them, and now I'm gonna get all of my bottles shaken up and opened to get ready for the Watermarble. Alright, so this is the order I'm going to be going in. It is American Pie, Rose Tart, Trace Parfait, Thin Mint, Creme the Cantaloupe, Pink Lady Finger, and Violet Eclair. So, let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna start by just dropping one drop of American Pie in there. Then I'm gonna go in with my Rose Tart. And you're just dropping one drop. If you want your color to appear darker, then put more than one, but I'm just doing one. I just put in Trace Parfait. Now I'm gonna go in with my Thin Mint. Cream the Cantaloupe. Pink Lady Finger and Violet Eclair. And then I'm just going to continue to do that until I feel my bullseye is big enough for all of my fingers. Okay, so I just finished my design, and I'm just moving all of my polish bottles aside. And now I'm gonna make the design. And as you can see in my speed up section, that I was moving my stick around the edges here. That just spreads it out so that you have more room to put more polish in, since I am doing all of my fingers. So I'm going to make a stripe design. And be sure not to go all the way to the edge when you make your designs, because as you can tell, when I just dipped in there, my design started to pool a little bit because it's already dry over here. And as you can also see right now on camera, I am wiping my orange stick, so you want to do that after every dip into the water. Now, you don't have to use an orange stick. You can use an orange stick, a toothpick, a like kebab skewer, a safety pin, anything that you have laying around, or even a small dotting tool. Anything that you have laying around that is pointy to make a design with. So I'm just gonna make a design in here, and like I said, I'm doing all my fingers, so I'm gonna make it so that I have enough room in the design area that I'm using to dip all my fingers in. I think that the colors spread really well. I did have to give it a little bit of help by going around the sides, but other than that, I think that they did spread really well, so I'm happy with how it turned out. So I like this design, and now I'm just gonna set this aside here and dip in my fingers. Now, what you want to do is you want to grab a cotton swab or just your orange stick and just clean up the excess, even though it looks like I caught most of it, tape. Be sure not to touch your design, it could ruin it. So just be really careful. And now, slowly pull it out of the water. Put a towel or a tissue down because your hands will be wet. But here's a close up of what our marble looks like. And now I'm just gonna peel off the tape on one of them just so you can see what it looks like. And if you don't use tape, or if you use liquid palisade or anything like that, it'll be pretty minimal cleanup, but if you don't use anything to protect your nails, it can hurt your nails from the chemicals and things, but it can also make you have to use a lot more nail polish remover because of all the cleanup you have to do. I really like that one. It actually kind of looks like a rainbow almost if you look at it. There's a little bit of striping over here, but I like that. So I'm gonna keep that. And now I'm just gonna peel the tape off of the rest of my fingers. And then I'll be back to show you the cleanup and the final look. Alright, so here's what I have after I took off my tape. And now what I'm doing is just taking a cotton swab or Q-tip, and I'm just taking it dipped in a container of nail polish remover to remove all of the excess polish. There really isn't that much. You can always build your tape up higher so that you don't have to do what I'm doing right now to clean it. But, and plus you have to clean that little part there, but mostly it's pretty minimal and you don't have to do much. Of course, after you use all this nail polish remover on your skin, you probably want to apply like a hand or cuticle oil or a massaging lotion, or a moisturizing lotion, my bad, and that'll really help keep your hands nice and soft and don't get dry and cracked from you putting nail polish remover right on it. And as you can see, you do get a couple mess ups. As you can see, there's a little mess up on my nail, but once I put on the top coat, you won't be able to see it. And plus, you can always get a little dotting tool or a striping brush and fix your mistakes. So I'm gonna finish cleaning up, and then I will come back and show you guys the final product. Okay, so here's our final product. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Like and comment down below more Watermarble requests so that I can try my best to make them happen. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys. And remember, it's Lime Green Girly Nails. Find me on Instagram at limegreengirly.nails. Bye, everybody.